Hello again, Mr. Trill. I want to cover one more topic before I head home this afternoon. You might notice I keep seeing the same shirt in some of these videos. I want to talk about how do we read graphs, analyze things like domain and range, relative max and mins. How do I describe where a graph is constant, increasing, or decreasing? And really just pick this graph apart. Let's talk first about roots. Where are the roots or the zeros? Or my particular book uses this term, where the zero is at. Or solutions. Where are these? This all says the same thing, by the way. Where are the root zeros or the solutions of this graph? You find solutions all the time. Every time you solve an equation, use a quadratic formula, use synthetic division if you're looking for solutions, factoring. What do you find when you find a solution to an equation? Well, graphically, what you're finding is where the graph crosses the x-axis. This graph crosses the x-axis at negative 4, 1, and positive 4. So the solutions, the zeros, and the roots, well, that's it. It is x equals negative 4, 1, and positive 4. These are the solutions, the zeros, the roots of this graph. If you have a t83 or 84, and you want to find the next intercept, you're going to look for a zero. Where is the y-intercept? Well, the y-intercept is where it crosses the y-axis. That's a value of 3, so the y-intercept is either 3, or your textbook might write it as 0, 3 if you're naming it as a coordinate. Let's talk about something that my students have recently found to be a little bit more confusing. Where is the graph increasing? Where is the graph? I read graphs left to right, and so should you. As you read the graph left and right, where is the graph going up? Now, I know going up, you might go, well, it's going up here. Well, a lot of kids will say, well, it increases to 4. Well, the highest y value here is 4, and we'll talk about that in a minute when I do relative maximum. But when you ask for a graph, when you're asking where is the graph increasing, that means as I uncover this graph, if you see the graph going up, then the graph is increasing. And then I want the x values. Along the x-axis, where is the graph going up? Well, it's way down here, and it's coming up and coming up and coming up as I read it left to right, and it stops going up when I get to negative 1. I'm going to write my answers in interval notation since I'm enforcing that in my pre-calculus class. But it is, so it might look a little bit funny, but it is increasing until you get to an x value of negative 1. So it's increasing from negative infinity, that's all these negative numbers going to the left forever, up until you get to negative 1. And then it stops increasing and starts to decrease. But on what increasing, and this is not the only place where the graph increases, it also increases from 2 to 3, 4, 5, 6. It starts to increase at this bottom, this relative minimum. It starts to increase until I get up here, and I don't want to say that y value because I don't want that to stick in your head. It increases from 2 to 6. So it increases from negative 1 to negative infinity to 1, or from positive 2. Let me make sure I count that right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Good. This is along the x-axis where you see the graph going up. Let's highlight the decreasing in a different color. Where is the graph decreasing? Well, as you read the graph left to right, where do you see the graph going down? Again, I do not want, and the textbooks will not want a y value answer. They want to know along the x-axis, where is the graph falling? It reaches the top at the x value of negative 1, and it falls until you get to that x value of 2 that we just used for the increasing part, because after it falls, it must rise. So it decreases from negative 1 to positive 2. Good. I'm going to kind of keep scrolling my answers down as I go. What about this idea of constant, which you might have heard about? Where is the graph constant. Where is the graph as you read it left to right not changing? Well, there it is right there. Along these values, the graph, the x is increasing, but the y is staying the same. That means the graph is constant. So the graph is constant from an x value of 6, and then it goes to the right forever. So if you're doing inequality notation, that means it's a constant where x is greater than 6. In interval notation, it starts at 6, and it goes to infinity and beyond. OK, anyway, what about the top of the graph? Like, this is kind of rising and falling. So if you rise and fall, you've made a peak in your graph. We call that relative minimum. If it never were to go up again, it would be called an absolute maximum. But we're going to just use relative maximum at the time. Did I just say minimum? Anyway, that's the top. So it's a maximum. OK. So where is my relative maximum point? My relative maximum occurs at, or is at, negative 1, 4. If you have a textbook really encouraging and emphasizing the use of function notation, you may see that as f of negative 1 equals 4, saying that your relative maximum of 4 is occurring at the x value of negative 2. So use whatever your teacher wants for these answers. 7. Where is the relative minimum? Where's the bottom of the curve? Is there even one even made? If this curve were to raise up, hit the peak, and then fall down forever, if it, you know, like an upside down parabola, there would be no relative minimum. But I do have one in this graph, and it's right here. It's falling down until you get to a y value of negative 2 at 2. So we have a relative minimum. The slope goes from positive to, or excuse me, the slope goes from negative to positive at the point 2, negative 2. So we have a relative minimum at 2, negative 2, or, again, emphasizing the function notation, the function has a relative minimum at negative 2 or of negative 2 at the x value of 2. Again, just use whatever notation your teacher is looking for in this graph. Domain and range. Well, the domain of a graph, one more time, if you have watched some of the other videos, the domain of the graph is what x values does the graph include? Well, this graph comes way from the left, does a little squiggle, and keeps shooting over to the right. So this has an x value of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, negative 7. This point has an x value of negative 6. This point has an x value of negative 5, negative 4. This point has an x value of negative 1. Here's an x value of 0 being used. This graph contains and uses along its points all of the x's. So the domain is going to be your x values from negative infinity to positive infinity. Or if your book is not using interval notation, you would say that the domain is all real numbers. I will not, because for my kids, because I'm trying to enforce the use of interval notation. What is the range of this graph? We're just picking this apart, same old picture. What y values are included along this graph? We got really small y values. You're coming up from negative infinity. You come up to 4. You drop back down again. So I'm using some of these y values again twice, actually even 3 times. It falls down again, falls up, and then it stops, and it goes flat. So we have y values of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're using y values of negative 6, negative 10, negative 20, negative infinity. We got y values of negative 3, negative 2, negative 1. We have y values of 0. You get my point here? All these points are using different y values from negative infinity all the way up until we get to a y value of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're using the highest y value that we use is 5. So the range of this graph, a little tired at the end of the day, I hope I didn't say the wrong word there for a second, but the range of this graph goes from, well, it is y values, And it goes from negative infinity up until you get to a y value of 5. So the range is negative infinity to 5. Now, for those of you in my pre-calc class and anyone else using integral notation, that 5 is a concrete value. It does get used. This is going right along the line y equals 5. So use that square bracket to indicate that it's actually being used. And that's your range. If you were using integral notation, or excuse me, inequality notation, it would be y is less than or equal to 5. And I think I have a little bit of time left just to make a slight change to this graph and explain again what the square bracket stuff is going on. If my, that would change some of my answers from previous, okay? So keep in mind, I just changed my graph, so forget all those other previous answers there for a second. If there was a horizontal asymptote, and that horizontal asymptote were y equals 5, and I draw this graph so that it comes up and approaches 5 from the bottom, but doesn't ever actually become 5. Well, first of all, now my graph is constant nowhere, so that previous answer would be out the window. And the graph comes up and it approaches, but doesn't quite use the y value of 5. My range would then go from negative infinity, and then instead of actually using the value of 5, the graph would just approach the value of 5 and you wouldn't actually use it. So there you go. Bam!